2009 Kia Forte was the first car equipped with intelligent variable transmission. The first Hyundai car that is equipped with IVT was the 2009 Hyundai Elantra. The IVT transmission was introduced to India by Kia Seltos in the year of 2019. The first Hyundai car that is equipped with IVT in India was the BS6 Hyundai Creta model, and 1.5 liter engine option have the IVT transmission option. Similarly, the BS6 Hyundai Verna also have the IVT transmission option in its 1.5 liter petrol engine option. Now look at what are the variations in the intelligent variable transmission compared to a normal CVT. First, we are using a chain belt instead of a push belt, and we have step shifting option as well as sport mode. Intelligent variable transmission is also capable of providing higher fuel economy compared to normal CVT. We won't be able to find the variation in IVT if we don't know about continuously variable transmission. So let's look at the variations. It is a sliced figure of intelligent variable transmission. Here you can see the chain belt instead of push belts that is used in conventional continuously variable transmission system. The working principle of IVT is very much similar to the continuously variable transmission, which is using two pulleys for providing various gear ratios to satisfy various driving conditions. The two pulleys are variable diameter pulleys, and the pulleys are able to move axially for providing various diameters, which eventually lead to various gear ratios in the transmission. So it will be able to satisfy various driving conditions as well to provide better performance from the engine. I already said there is two pulleys. One is the output pulley, one is the input pulley. So the input pulley is connected to the engine, which makes it the driving pulley. The output pulley is connected to the driving wheels and the driving lines as well as final drives, which makes it the output pulley and the driven pulley. So the top pulley is the input pulley and the lower pulley is the output pulley. We know that the diameter is inversely proportional to the speed, which makes higher diameter lead to lower speed, and lower diameter will lead to higher speed. If we have lower diameter in the output pulley, it will rotate at very much higher speed, which will lead to a transmission operation which is very much similar to the top gear of a conventional transmission. If we have higher diameter in the output pulley, it will reduce the speed of the output, which makes it operates very much similar to the lower gears or first gear of a conventional transmission system. So we will be able to maintain various torque as well as speed in the transmission while varying the diameter of the two pulleys, which makes it possible for providing various gear ratios. We have to provide an external force in the pulley for varying the diameter. The external force is taken from the centrifugal clutch that is connected to the engine. So as the engine RPM increases, the centrifugal force also increases, which make the pulley to increase the diameter of the input. So it will eventually decrease the diameter of the output full pulley by increasing the speed in the output to provide higher speed ratios. The IVT transmission have wide gear span than a normal CVT. So it will be able to provide more infinite gear ratios, and it will be able to provide better performance and higher fuel economy compared to the conventional continuously variable transmission system. It is a major modification in the new intelligent variable transmission that is developed by Kia and Hyundai. And the second thing is, we know that by checking the working principle of IVT, we can crack that it is never able to provide the stepping gear shifting that is similar to the 6-speed automatic or manual transmission. But the modification in the intelligent variable transmission made it possible. Because by using a centrifugal clutch, we will never be able to provide the stepping gear shifting experience. But instead of that, we are not using a centrifugal clutch, we are using a hydrostatic fluid driven variator. So by maintaining various pressures in the variator, we will be able to provide various gear ratios. A particular pressure means a particular gear ratio. By maintaining a particular 6 particular gear ratio, we only need to provide 6 various pressures in the fluid. So So we will be able to provide the same driving experience of driving a 6-speed automatic transmission by using the intelligent variable transmission by maintaining various pressures in the variator. So we will be more flexible to operate. It made it possible for equipping a paddle shifting mechanism in the car that is equipped with IVT, which provides more better experience in driving hills. The main disadvantage of internal combustion engine is its very low torque band. The engine is only able to provide peak torque and peak power only at a specific RPM. So if we have to maintain a better fuel economy and better torquey experience, we have to maintain the engine at the sweet spot. But you might be noticed that by driving the conventional transmission, which is a manual transmission or even a 6-speed or 7-speed automatic transmission, the engine RPM will get dropped. You may notice this in the tachometer of the engine. The engine RPM will drop quickly when the gear is getting shifted, which means the engine RPM will shift from the sweet spot of the engine, which will eventually reduce the fuel economy of the engine. But the CVT and IVT are more able to maintain the sweet spot for providing higher fuel economy. But the more wider gear span of the intelligent variable transmission made it more easy to maintain the sweet spot compared to the conventional CVT. So IVT are more fuel economical compared to the conventional CVT as well. So it will make the ultimate torque on demand compared to the normal CVT transmission system. It's actually a major advantage thanks for the new technology that is developed by Hyundai and Kia. If we were using the centrifugal clutch, if we are demanding a higher acceleration, the throttle will be wide open and the engine RPM will be slightly will increase only after getting enough fuel and fuel as well as air from the intake planer. So only after that the transmission will get modified only after the speed variation of the engine. But if we were able to modify the transmission before engine RPM changes, the IVT is made it possible by sensing the driver's demand and making the modification and transmission before even the engine RPM even gets changes. So we will get better higher throttle response by using an intelligent variable transmission, because we will be able to maintain various pressures in the variator of IVT system. This is why Hyundai and Kia's cars that is equipped with IVT is able to provide better throttle response compared to the conventional continuously variable transmission. Let's look at or let's summarize all these variations. We are using a modified belt chain in this IVT system instead of the push belt in the conventional CVT system, and we are able to maintain various pressures in the variator, which eventually lead to various gear ratios and more flexible operation of the continuously variable transmission, which made it an IVT. So we will be able to provide better performance from the same engine by equipping or retrofitting it into a IVT system, and it have wider gear span, which will provide more fuel economy as well. And we have a sport mode because we are able to sense the driver demand, as well as we can modify the transmission according to the demand of the driver. And we also have a stepping driving experience as well. Thank you for watching my video and give a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for updated videos. And hope you have any doubts, leave that in the comment below. Thank you.